moving up to super heavyweight. He's moving up to your weight class.
It's so healthy.
He's moving up to your weight class. Dillian,
salad.
Moving up to your weight class.
Salad, turkey, and soup.
Where are you sitting, Paulie?
I don't know. Wherever I find a seat.
Dillian's such a cool dude, man. He's very chill, but he turns it on in the ring like no one else.
Yeah, he does, man. That's the way he's supposed to be. That's a true mark of a fighter.
The enthusiasm, Paulie?
Yeah. Passionate about what he does.
You're like that too.
Well, yeah. At one time I was.
We are talking to the best broadcaster commentator on TV, Paulie Malignaggi. This is Breakfast of Champions. He's working on his comeback at 175.
Yeah, no.
It's healthy stuff,
we
right?
Got turkey, cheese, and peppers, and tomato.
And soup.
A little salad. Yeah, soup. So, that's my lunch.
The odd makers have Broner Pacquiao at 2-1. Is that right? Is that off? Is that...
I mean, you know, I'd say it's all right. You know, it can go both ways. You know, I think it's probably favorite Pacquiao, so maybe odds all right.
It actually feels, just being here and at the press conference yesterday, like it's a real pay-per-view party. It's a packed house. It's not... You announce a fight, you never know if people will resonate towards it.
Yeah, well, I think this is a very big crossover fight. I mean, both guys have crossover potential, you know?
So now that Crawford Khan is official, what do you think?
You know, I think a couple of years ago, this was a very good fight, but I don't think Khan can really compete with him now.
If Adrian wins, what does he do next?
Maybe Mayweather? You know,
how big would that be?
It might be the biggest, because it will be a promotion, like, for the record books, you know?
And if not, it may be Pacquiao Mayweather?
Yeah, people have seen it, but I'm sure they'll buy into it again, you know?
A lot of people don't give Adrian a chance, and I don't know why.
I think it's a good fight, and Pacquiao's not exactly a spring chicken, so he's got a chance, Broner's got a chance, and Broner also's, you know, very good in his own right. It's a good fight.
I've been in the gym with him every day this week. He's more focused, no joke, like business play. He's tunneled, zeroed in on this, on the target.
Mm-hmm. Well, he should be. It's definitely his biggest career fight, and he's had plenty of big fights. This is the biggest.
And what do you think about Dillian White if he fights Joshua again? Different?
Great fight. Listen, the champions in the heavyweight division are no joke. But Dillian also deserves a shot at him, you know? He's been very good, and I think he's up there to compete with him.
All right, there you have Paulie. We'll let you eat. Right here at the media center, one of the most popular people. There's Roy. It was his birthday yesterday. You know that, right?
Roy, how old is he?
He is 50.
50. Wow, the big 5-0.
Yeah. He might fight Khabib.
Yeah.
He told me he might fight Khabib in boxing.
Wow. That's something.
I'm sure he still wins. He beats Khabib even at 50.
Yeah. In boxing.
Yeah, boxing. So there you have it. Roy Jones Jr. here at the media center. Paulie, make sure to follow at Paul Malignaggi.
Paul Malignaggi and across the board.
Everywhere.
Might bring back the podcast too soon.